First of all, we've always operated as if we're fully regulated both in the local country and the U.S., with the assumption that the regulations are coming, and we want them to come. The Ugandan government hasn't completely figured out the regulatory structure for crypto, but other countries are moving fast. For example, Botswana came out with the first formal virtual asset service provider license, a license for crypto exchanges, recently, and we were the first company to obtain that license. So very formal regulation, similar to what you see in other similar fields. People buying crypto at large scale over WhatsApp groups or other similar informal markets. No consumer protections, right? No kind of governance. Most of the time it went well, sometimes it didn't.
So for us as Nigeria, even for Yellow Card, Nigerian payment process is P2P and is automated. So once we make a payment into an account, Yellow Card is able to pick it up automatically and credit your account. Whereas in Uganda, we don't have that, right? Your transfers in Uganda currently are not automated. So you see people depositing money into the bank and then we not being able to credit the customer because we've not received the deposit into our account until we receive that.
Maybe we'll take it sequentially and just tell us.